Hi, I'm Dr. Nathan Lee, one of the partners at Edina Plastic Surgery, and I'd like to go over the breast augmentation consult with you. You've expressed an interest in reshaping or enlarging the breast, and I want to find out what your history has been, where you are now, and where you would like to be. Now, my goals, typically with an augmentation, are natural look and an act and feel. And to do that, we make a space where the implant goes, known as the pocket. So the pocket is what makes this procedure work. So our pocket should allow motion of the implant because breasts move. So I want to maximize our cleavage potential, and I have to respect the fold when I'm making the pocket. On the outside, there is no stopping point like these two. That means you can keep going. The problem is the nerve that gives the nice feeling to the breast and nipple lives out here, and we want to respect that. The farther out you go, the thinner your tissue gets and the more you can see or feel the implant, so that's not desirable. Also, if the pocket is wide and you go to the beach and you lay in the sand and your implants go down, it leaves a dent here. That does not look good. So we don't want the pocket wide. I have to respect the cleavage and the fold, and I need room. So the only direction left is up. So if we look at your natural anatomy, the pec major muscle goes from the collarbone to the fold, from the sternum over to the side. That is exactly what I was just talking about for our pocket. So our implant goes under the pec major, over the pec minor. There's a small muscle under there. They glide across each other. There's naturally a space there. That's where we're going to put the implant. Okay? At surgery, I have total control over the pocket, so we're going to have a nice pocket. However, blood or bacteria in the pocket will cause inflammation and the pocket may shrink a little bit. That's where scar, caps, or contracture comes from. So our main goal, no blood in the pocket, no bacteria. You can help by avoiding blood thinners, things like aspirin, Motrin, Neupren, Aleve, green tea, vitamin E, fish oil, ibuprofen, red wine. There's a lot of them. And actually, during surgery, I spend more of my time making sure there's no bleeding than anything else I do. I want absolutely no blood in the pocket. And the last thing I do before I put the last suture in, wash out the pocket with antibiotic. I want it very sterile in there, and it washes any last blood proteins out. So our pocket is ready. What are we going to do with it? Today in the office, we're going to look and see how wide the natural tissue is. I want to fill that, but not go wider. Breasts that look bad are too wide. I also want to see where it would look nice if the breast started down to the fold. The fold is kind of fixed. So this is the diameter of an implant that will work well on your frame. So we have that piece of information. Now we need to decide how far forward we would like that to go. That's the profile. So we're going to talk a little bit about implants. Basically, all implants have a silicone elastomer shell. We're just deciding if we want a saline filling or a silicone gel filling. They have good points and bad points. Let's start with saline. They all go through a 3-centimeter incision because the shell goes in empty and then I fill it up. Since I'm filling it up, it's adjustable. They're inexpensive. Your body is filled with saline, so it's a bag of IV fluid. The fluid goes right out of the IV bag, right into the implant through a closed system to avoid any kind of infection risk. We get to the butt part of saline. If you've ever had a waterbed and you fill it half full, you notice it's very soft, but it's also very wavy. So you keep filling the bed to get rid of the waviness and it'll start to get firmer. So the bugger of saline implants is making them soft and controlling the wave. So let's say that we filled your water bed half full with Jell-O pudding. So a Jell-O pudding is thicker, so when it's half full, the bed is soft, but does not have the waves. And that's sort of the principle of a silicone gel implant. Thicker material means the implant isn't as full, so they're softer and more natural. So if you sleep on your stomach, you get a chiropractic, you get a massage, it's easier to lay on gel implants. They're more huggable and they feel more like natural tissue. But They are pre-filled at the factory, so they don't go through a 3-centimeter incision, but 3.5 centimeter. We have a little insertion sleeve that'll sneak that through a pretty small incision. Gel costs more than water, so they're more expensive than saline. But they do have the more natural feel and acting. That neither implant is bad. Both manufacturers are excellent. It's sort of a personal decision. You look at the pros and cons and pick the one you're interested in. Now, the uncomfortable part of augmentation is when you put that implant under the muscle and it stretches the muscle out. It's not the breast gland itself. The gland is designed to get big and small. It's good at it, and that won't be the issue. So while you're asleep, we put a local anesthetic block in there that lasts for 3 days. That's very helpful. When you stretch muscle, it gets spasms. So one of our medicines, anti-spasm medicine, we have a good pain pills if you need it, and an antibiotic as a precaution. Now, one thing you should be aware of is that implants do block mammograms a little bit, so they'll take the regular view of the mammogram, then an oblique view to help pick up space they might miss. Remember, our pocket is tall and thin, though, and you can push the implant up high and do the mammogram down low. Another thing that is good to know is self-exam is actually more accurate with an implant than without, because it takes your breast tissue and thins it out over a smooth surface, so you can do a nice self-exam. I would suggest you start doing those. As far as going back to work, we do have to heal this pocket, and I want it to stay the size and shape we've made. So I will have you move the implant in the pocket, displacement exercises I call those, 3 times a day for a couple of months until the pocket is the shape and size we want it to be. Meanwhile, I don't want any blood in there, so aggressive exercise like the elliptical machine, high impact aerobics, stuff like that probably should be avoided for 6 or 7 weeks. You probably can run at 3 weeks with a very supportive sports bra. And back to work depends on what your job is, but typically 5 to 7 days works pretty well. That's a breast augmentation consult in a nutshell. And we do have the vector imager, which could be very helpful for seeing what you might look like. And we hope you'll consider a dynaplastic surgery.